This topic will cover Azure Container Services and what all we provide within within Azure as it relates to container services, which are, for example, a Docker Container Service. And so Kale's going to take us through a brief overview of what a container service is and how we could use that within Azure to create our applications.
Sure. So I think it's good to start off understanding what the heck we would use a container service for to begin with. And there seems to be so many of them on the market that we don't distinguish between them. So I think that's the first thing I always run into with people that want to deal with containers. Some people come from a Docker background, which is a very popular container service. And then you have things like Service Fabric and ACS inside Azure, and they're like, I don't know which one to use for what. Like, what should I be doing here? And so I wanted to kind of draw out what the benefit these container services are to you as someone who wants to host and run your application in a scalable way, and how that kind of compares and contrasts with what we have in Azure from like Service Fabric and ACS. So the first thing to remember is this is a virtualization technology. And if you read any of the background from like Mark Rusinovich or any of these people that are very plugged into this market on the container side, it's really about thinking about what we did first was we had, you know, basically our traditional hypervisor, and then inside of there we ran, you know, guest VMs, and that was our virtualization, right? So we could load our applications onto there, and that's essentially what we're doing in Azure with pretty much everything. No matter if it's PaaS or not, there's a virtual machine behind the scenes running that thing. Whether that thing gets pre-provisioned for you automatically and transparently, that's kind of beside the point. There's actually a virtual machine. But if we look at what a container service would do, again, so basically what we want to do is abstract away this notion of a machine, a virtual machine. So we at the foundation of what we're doing here, we're going to have a ton of VMs running to do our stuff for us. And then on top of that, we're basically going to add layers to do this container service for us. Now, Docker's a really kind of famous one. It's very well known. And Docker Compose is some of the tooling around how do you kind of build those clusters of machines out there. Because when you build a Docker cluster, you want to build it in such a way that up here, we're basically going to containerize our workloads, right? So up here is going to be our apps. And a container, what you can think of it as, this guy is going to be your app plus the environment that it needs to run, right? And really the point is, like, we can basically establish what we need to run our application, and then we can have these densely packed into these virtual machines down here. So we could have like many, many containers running on like 4 VMs. Or we can have tons of VMs and just a few containers spread over across them. So we have this kind of decoupling between the actual hardware and this container, this environment that our app thinks it's running inside of. And so this is where something like Docker comes in really well and can fill that need. But the problem is once you start deploying these containers out here, now you need something to manage them. Right, you can't just, this is great, you can actually orchestrate this, you can spin up containers, and you can do this manually yourself through all the tooling out there. But when you do that, that's not really a production type application, right? So what happens if this guy dies? What happens with the container? Like, what's gonna happen with our user experience? What's gonna happen if something actually fails in the app at that level? How do we kind of guard against these things? And that's where this additional layer comes in to kind of, I'll call it the orchestration layer, right? So the orchestration and the scheduling type layer. And what we see there is stuff like when you hear the word Mesosphere, if you've heard that in the market, Mesosphere is one of these orchestration engines that sits on top of these container technologies and allows you to basically, it'll manage your cluster for you. So it'll say like, I'm gonna make sure that these all containers get deployed in specific nodes. And if one of those nodes fails, like let's say in this case, this guy's still running, he has an X on him, but let's say this guy fails, he may take that container that was running there and put them on this guy. Now this guy has two containers running on him, maybe. And then maybe when you add more virtual machines over here, we can actually, you know, load balance and put that guy back over here so each one's running one. You know, traditionally we run more than one container in a virtual machine. We run tons of them in there. But this is just a simple use case. And so the idea around all this ACS service that you hear, Azure Container Service, is around this model right here. Is around not just like running a Docker command and having a virtual machine behind it, but actually spinning up the entire infrastructure from Mesosphere and Marathon, so a scheduling and an orchestration engine, to being able to manage the health of that cluster. So it'll make sure that, you know, one of these is going to be named the master up here, that he's going to keep control of your configuration. can't lose your config because you said, hey, I want to make sure I at least run this one 3 times or this one 4 times. All that configuration has to be stored somewhere. So it will provision nodes out here or containers out here to just manage that piece of the cluster. And it'll do it for you. So you get these nice like GUI interfaces, and Azure's basically orchestrating this for you. So when you go in to provision it, and I'll pop to the portal for just 1 second. When you pop over here to Azure Container, you'll see there's a bunch of them here, but if we just pick the generic one for now, the top level one, it actually gives you, the template has some options in it. So the first thing it's going to ask you is like, okay, so for the entire cluster, we're going to have to give it a machine name. We're going to have to give it an SSH key. You can use something like PuttyGen, which is what I'm using here. And this stuff's all documented. You can look it up. And I just want to show you like where you can actually start picking how you want to run your cluster. So on the second option here under the framework configuration, you can see the orchestration configuration of DCOS. That's Mesosphere. That's the data center operating system. That's their premier kind of product for running and managing containers. And then we have Swarm, Docker Swarm, which is comprised of Docker and Docker Compose in order to run your application under that model. Either way works. It's just which one you're more used to and want to kind of absorb, or maybe what you've used in the past. If you're very heavily centered around Docker and you've used Docker Compose, Swarm's probably the place for you. DCOS is more of a kind of enterprise. It's a really big feature from Mesosphere that's getting a lot of traction in the industry. Now, people see this and they say, okay, great. So this can run my containers, like my Docker containers out there, and it can orchestrate, schedule, manage the health, do all these kind of nice things for me. So I understand that, but where does Service Fabric fit into this? So Service Fabric, you can think of it, it's again a container service, but it's a Microsoft-specific container service. So we've built APIs into our framework. So we do something very similar to what Docker's doing here. We'll break it up into containers. We'll do the management. So Service Fabric does all that stuff for you. It'll make sure that whenever we have a node out there, if one goes unhealthy, how does it elect another one? So that we can make sure that we don't lose any kind of application. So you can have a stateful or a stateless app. Like typically, if you had a stateful application, that means some server is actually holding some state of the application. And if that server dies, there's probably going to be a bad user experience, right? Because we just lost some data or we lost some cache or something and it has to be rebuilt. So Service Fabric actually allows you to hook into some APIs, some lower level APIs, and it itself will make sure that the replication happens automatically. So for instance, if we had some data, like let's say the canonical case is like an array of data, a collection, right? So we have an array of data that our application's using. There's a primary node in a Service Fabric cluster that's actually servicing the request. If that guy dies, there's a bunch of secondaries. They will take over the role, but he's already replicated that because he made sure that while he was receiving those requests from you, they were actually being replicated to the secondaries. So it's all transparently handled for you. You just use different classes inside your application. So instead of using like an iDictionary class, you'll use one of the ones from the Service Fabric, which actually will maintain persistence of that data. So in that case, it's a little bit of a code change. So typical to kind of our PaaS model, where you have to make a small code change, but the benefit is huge. Because once you get into that space, now you can basically grow to an unlimited size, however big you need to grow. Because basically you can say, here's all the virtual machines that are servicing my request, here's my containers, and I can kind of orchestrate how dense I want each container. Like I might have a container that just services login requests. And maybe that thing gets heavily loaded like on a Monday morning. I can make sure that I spread that over more nodes. The other interesting thing is the VM scale set part of Azure actually plays into it. So the VM scale set is a way for us to basically say, hey, I have this virtual machine with this image, and here's how I replicate it. So you can basically just drag a slider, or in your application can say, hey, I need 5 more of those machines. Behind the scenes, because it's in a scale set, it'll say, oh, I use this image, and I just go provision myself. He gets added to the pool. Containers start to flow onto those nodes, your application's scaling automatically. And so think of it as like if you're in a Microsoft kind of centered world, in the .NET world, those kind of things, Service Fabric is great. If you're in the Docker, those kind of worlds, the ACS is really a great model for you to run your containers up there. And that is our module on Azure Container Services.